Trash. Straight up trash, but it happens.
Yeah, good games, yeah, bad games. This is another one of my bad games. But we're going to show if I'm good or not is how I come back the next game. So if I come back next game stronger, it's going to show what type of player I am. If I come back weaker, then I'm more just sulking and thinking about the last game. We just played Shanghai. They saw they was hitting everything against us. Then we went to Lao Ning before that.
Yeah.
Right. We got the hardest road trip.
What you need to do today?
Stay aggressive. You know, I was a little aggressive in the first quarter. I got to pick and choose my spots offensively. Defensively, you know, still, you know, do what I do, rebound, run the floor, but just be a little bit more aggressive offensively.
Well, all three of them had at least dub. Like they had 20s, but all three of them had like dub something, so.
They should be in the playoffs with them three.
Yeah, exactly.
Some of the things that went wrong last game, why y'all lost?
A lot of pressure. I think everybody, you know, wants to win, so. You know, everybody have pressure, so I think especially Dean, his body is not good, you know, long time no play, so he's very important to us because he has 25 points average, you know, it's important. So we lost our MVP, so we lost. We need to come back. We have four games. For sure we come back.
It's an amazing feeling coming from a small city where I'm from because not too many people do that. You know, you have some guys that made it to the NBA out of my city, but they never experienced going overseas, playing for different countries. You know, and then you got some who just went overseas and never went to the NBA. But it's an amazing feeling, man. It's different because you get to see the world by playing basketball. You meet people that you never thought you'd meet because of basketball, playing the sport you love to play. And you get paid to do it. So I know there's a lot of players out there that would rather play basketball and not go to school because school ain't for everybody. I know that. I've seen a lot of guys go through school and it just didn't work out for them, but they still was good players outside of basketball. Just know basketball will take you to amazing places. You just got to want to do it and want to put the work in. When you was younger, you was playing basketball, then you never thought about overseas. You always knew about NBA, huh? I never knew about overseas basketball when I was little. It's crazy how social media and everything changes. And now people know more about overseas.
But I mean, wasn't even really thinking, like, obviously you think the league, but you just think of every level. Like, I'm going to be the best at this level. Like, you know what I'm saying? High school, then college. Like,
yeah, with me, it was like, man, I got to make the NBA to take care of family. That's all you kept.
That's all you kept
thinking. And then now you got guys that's like, man, I know I ain't got no NBA talent. I'm going to go overseas and play basketball and be the best overseas player I can be. Then you didn't have that. So it's like everybody hopes was to make it to the NBA, even the ones who didn't have the best talent.
I think it's it's more publicized now too though than what it used to be.
And when we was younger, guys went overseas, they didn't have phones, they didn't have FaceTime, none of that.
And they got the teams, organizations got more money, countries got more money now.
Yeah.
They see how much we make and then some cats is like, man, I made $20,000 all year.
Right.
Like, what?
Some guys still doing that because they're trying to build their resume. So some people think it's just a cakewalk, man. It's a grind.
It's like, what, 100?
Even in the NBA, it's grinds for some guys. Guys living on 2 years advance money. Because when I was there in Toronto, they was like, if you want, you can have your money in advance. I'm like, really? Like, and I started thinking, I guess the stories is true. Guys do get they money in advance. You always think about your next job. You always really think about what are you doing it for.
With me, I'm doing it to be the best I can be, to be the best to ever come out of my area, which is Carbondale. My advice to some of the other guys is don't get bored with success. Success is not something you want to get bored with. If you reach to a point where you're successful, then go do something else and be successful in something else. Like me, I've won championships, but I didn't stop there. I want to win more. I always look for my next high, what is going to challenge me to be better. So I tell the guys that never be bored with success, because it's a great thing once you get it.
I do not believe that any of us have dreams that were not given to us for the purpose of accomplishing those particular dreams. See, sometimes we can't say, I can do that. But what we can say, that it's possible that I can have my dream. As we run toward it, as we work on it day in and day out, no one, ladies and gentlemen, could have convinced me when I started out just over 6 years ago working on my dream. And I want you to think about whatever your dream is. Because I was willing to take a chance, and most people won't do that. Most of the people that you talk to try and bring them into the business, these are not risk takers. Most people have done all that they're ever going to do. They raise a family, they earn a living, and then they die. But people who are running toward their dreams, life has a special kind of meaning. And here's what I will share with you, that in the process of working on your dreams, you are going to incur a lot of disappointment, a lot of failure, a lot of pain, a lot of setbacks, a lot of defeats. But in the process of doing that, you will discover some things about yourself that you don't know right now. What you will realize is that you have greatness within you. What you'll realize is that you're more powerful than you can ever begin to imagine. What you will realize is that you are greater than your circumstances, that you don't have to go through life being a victim. Someone's opinion of you does not have to become your reality.
Yesterday, when we were getting high, you were invited. You would have liked it. I know you all too well. I said that we could kiss the past goodbye, but you weren't excited. There's no way to fight it. Stay, but shout it, here I go. Should I spend a weekend in Vegas? I'm living inside a moment, not taking pictures to save it. I mean, how could I forget? My memories never faded. I can't relate to these haters. My enemies never made it. I am still here with who I started with. The game needed life, I put my heart in it. I blew myself up, I'm on some martyr shit. Carry the weight for my city like a cargo ship. I'm 23 with a money tree. Growing more too, I just planted 100 seeds. It's ironic cause my mother was a florist, and that's how she met my pops. And now my garden is enormous. It's happening Penny Lane. Just like you said, I avoided the coke game and went with Sprite instead. That's word to the millions that they putting up. I'm trying to do better than good enough. What am I afraid of? This is supposed to be what dreams are made of. But people I don't had a ton to hang with always look at me and say the same shit. They say, you promised me you would never change. You promised me you would never change.
Thank you. Better than the team. We let them play with more energy than us, like the first quarter, and it make it tough. But if they do exactly what they did the second quarter, which was pick up the energy level, it should be an easy game.
you gonna learn the game playing in this?
It's easy. He just right now he learned leadership, nigga. When you here as a mayor, you really gotta take over. Some guys don't want to take on that leadership and that all that burden of putting everything on your
back. It's a terrible way to learn basketball though. Now you can cook, you know what I'm saying? If you had talent, you can cook.
Young, well, I don't know if y'all did it, but most guys tell the kids, like, if they get them aggressive, go to the rack, shoot everything, just get aggressive.
But some guys still don't teach you the game, though.
It was a good basketball game. This shows what type of team we are. It shows what type of player I am. I came back stronger this game, didn't think, didn't worry about mistakes. I was just out there just hooping. Whether I missed or made it, I was on to the next play. And now we're on to the next game. We got to put this game behind us. We won, but it only lasts for a while.
Man, it's a good bounce back, man. You know, we haven't had too many games where we lost two in a row. You know, but we played against a top team last game and tried to give it their best and took an L. But last time took an L, but tonight we bounced back. We got a lot of games on the line to make the playoffs, man. So, you know, it's a good W overall. And, you know, we're going to Sichuan after this.
Expectation for next game, going back to play my old team.
I mean, at the end, it was, I mean,
you know how people do when they play their old teams. They want to play good. Me, I'm going to try to go in there with a clear mind, like I did tonight, and just go in there not worrying about my mistakes. Just go in there and hoop. Hopefully, I go for 40 because this is one of them games that I just got to play good. I got to.